Hello friends, welcome back to Let's Play Littlewood, the how-to series. The how-to series is a series that is aimed at targeting all the main and biggest questions that Littlewood gamers usually have. Today's episode is actually an episode that I really wanted to make for the longest time because it's about a topic that I struggled the most with when playing Littlewood myself. And that is, like the title of this video says, flower breeding. I struggled a lot with learning how to breed the flowers, but now that I've gotten the hang of it, I am here to give you guys the full flower breeding guide. I will put timestamps for each of the questions that I'm going to answer in the video. The first one is, how to get the first initial seedlings or flowers? And the second one is, how to get the watering can so that you can actually water your flowers and then breed them. The third and last question is, how to breed the flowers, meaning the correct layout and how to get each color. And I'll show you guys my layout right now, and I'll also show you what worked for me and how to get every single color that you can in the game so far. I'll put timestamps for each of those questions, so in case you guys only are confused about a certain question, you guys can skip right to the timestamps in the description box below. Alright, without further ado, let's jump right in the game! Alright guys, this is my current garden. Let's jump right ahead and show you guys how to get all of these beautiful flowers in your Littlewood game. To get the first initial seedlings and flowers to start your flower farm, you're gonna want to head to the Endless Forest. After you get to the Endless Forest, depending on how many whirly bugs you have, you're going to be able to get more chances at obtaining the first initial flowers. To get your flowers, you're going to want to head into a whirly bug. Sometimes there are flowers and sometimes there's not any. It just depends on luck. And once you see a flower, in order to take it, you step on top of it and you press the interaction button. There we go, we picked up one flower. And there's more than one different color that you can pick up in the Endless Forest. Right over here, I see two white, so I'm gonna pluck those. And then I'm gonna head right out and check the other forest. Alright, perfect! In the second forest, we have a red flower, and also a different variety. In the Endless Forest, you can find different varieties and different colors of flowers. Alright, now let's see one more time if we can find more flowers. Yes indeed, I see some little dewcap flowers right over here, so let's go ahead and pluck them. And to show you guys, these are the base flowers that you can collect in the Endless Forest. The white ones, the red ones, and the yellow ones. You can also find blue ones occasionally. Alrighty, now that we're back in town, we are ready to learn how to get the watering can. To get the watering can, you're gonna want to step foot into Bubsy's house. Here we are, this is Bubsy's house in my town. Inside Bubsy's house, you're gonna want to build the desk. And then, on the desk, it'll tell you a list of requests of what he wants his house to look like, and also certain requirements that he wants fulfilled. You're gonna want to complete everything on the very first page of his request in order to unlock Bubsy's first gift to you. There are a total of 3 pages of requirements and requests that he wants before he gives you each new gift. You only have to complete the very first page in order to unlock the watering can. So now I'm going to demonstrate how you can water your flowers. When you first set down your flowers, it's going to look a little like this. They're just gonna look like saplings and you can't actually water them yet. But after they've grown out, after you wait one day and they grow out, it's going to look like this. You'll see the full flower. And you're going to want to water them so that they can repopulate and make more flowers. In order to water them, you step on top of them like so, and you just press your interaction button. Watering does not consume any energy at all, and it waters in a 3x2 tile, like so. It's 3x2, 3x2, 3x2. Much like in real life, if you don't water your flowers, they won't grow. And and you'll know if you've watered them successfully because after you water them, they'll look all shiny like this. And the ones that haven't been watered are kind of dull and they're not shining. Now that we've learned how to pick your first initial seedlings and your first initial flowers, and you've learned how to get the watering can and how to water your flowers, it's time to learn how to breed the correct flowers. Let's jump right in. Alright, and now we are ready to breed those flowers. I've cleared out this big plot of land so that we can demonstrate the correct layout of how to breed your flowers, and also how to get the correct color combinations. Let's get started. But for me, the easiest way to breed my flowers was in this specific direction. I hear that there's more than one way, but this was just the most simple way for me, and I'm gonna show you guys how to do it. So right over here, I will set down a white zigzag that I've plucked from the endless forest, and then I'll set down a red zigzag. And because I want more of them to grow, I'm gonna leave a little bit of space, and then I'm gonna set down a red zigzag here, I'm gonna set down a red zigzag here, and then more white zigzags. Kind of like a diagonal shape, like so. Here we go. And they are ready to grow. And you're gonna notice right after you set down your flowers, you won't be able to water them just yet. They're just seedlings and so they don't need to be watered. So don't worry about that. Ta-da! Your seedlings will always grow out in one day's time. Now I'm gonna step on top of it and then water it. And remember, it waters in a 3x2 fashion. And watering does not take any energy at all. So don't worry. Go ahead and water all the flowers you want to. Good morning, guys! It is the next morning! And right over here, ta-da! We have some new seedlings growing through. What I do want us to notice is that, notice over here how this set of flowers doesn't have any seedlings growing around it, and also this set of flowers, it also doesn't have any seedlings growing around it. And the reason for that is, when you plant the flowers and water them, there's going to be a random chance of whether they sprout new seedlings or not. So you're just gonna have to keep watering them until you do get new seedlings. Now that we've covered the base layout that we need to do in order to breed flowers, we're going to jump into the correct color combinations. And ta-da! This will be your flower breeding guide and cheat sheet. Over here, in order to make this wicked flower right over here, you're going to need to combine a dew cap over here with a zigzag in just a diagonal shape, and then one of the days a little wicked flower will bloom. Right over here, in order to make this flower over here called the tootsie, this heart-shaped flower, you're gonna need a lollipop like this white one over here with a dew cap to make one tootsie. And in order to make this flower over here, which is called a floof, the one I'm standing on, you're gonna need to combine a dew cap with a zigzag. And I'll have all of the names of these flowers listed below it so that you can have an easy visual guide. And now let's move into the color combinations. In order to make a blue flower, there's a chance that you might find them in the endless forest. But if you need them and you can't find them, then you combine a white flower with a white flower to get the blue flower. If you need to get the pink flower, you'll combine a white flower with a red flower to get pink. In order to get the orange flower, you'll need to combine yellow with a red to get an orange. In order to get a purple flower, you'll need to combine the red one with the blue one to get purple. And for the most rare combination, right over here, this is called the rare color, you'll need to combine purple with another purple in order to get this combo. And I just want to show you guys my lovely flower museum. I'm almost complete with collecting all of the flowers myself. I'm just missing two over here. one lovely floof over here, and I'm also missing one lovely wicked flower over here. And then my museum for the flowers is complete! If you're also struggling with growing flowers, rest assured, I had to do them for a very long time. I put in quite a few hours of in real life time in order to breed all these. So if it takes you guys a little bit of time, rest assured, that is quite normal. I really hope you guys enjoyed this visual tutorial, and if it helped you, please let me know by giving a big thumbs up. And if you have any comments or questions at all, please feel free to leave me a comment below. I will do my best to get back to you as soon as I can. If you haven't subscribed to my videos yet and you want to see more gaming content from me, please do hit the subscribe button. I would absolutely love it if you joined my gaming family. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you guys soon again with more gaming content from me. Stay safe, stay healthy. Bye!